The same thing can happen today. We have to change our minds because we accept Jesus, but they made us to be religious people. No, we should never be a religious people, but a people that practice the God's word, the doer of the word. That's what God wants us. If we continue praying, oh Jesus, I need you, please heal me, you are denying all the Bible says, because the Bible says that the Lord took our infirmities and put upon Jesus. He suffered our diseases, our pains. So you must come before the Lord. I thank you because you healed me. And in the name of Jesus, I'm going to use your power. Then we rebuke the evil one, and the thing go away. When I was 20 years old, I became bad with my eyes. I didn't know that, but every afternoon, about 3 p.m., I had a strong headache. It seemed that my head would be divided in two parts. Every day. I had a shopping in Brazil in that time that I would sell clothes. I was in São Paulo in a fabric buying clothes. And I said to the owner of the company, Mrs. Raquel, I cannot continue to talk with you. I have to go to the pharmacy to buy medicine because every day at this time I have a strong headache. It's every day. Yes. He probably says, you have a problem in your eyes. Go to the doctor. And I went to the doctor when I got to Rio, where I live. And the doctor said, you have astigmatism. Put this glass. The headache went away. But if I took off the glass at the afternoon, that the pain will come. Then I was very angry because I belong to Jesus since I was 6 years old. I was the first one in my family that went to the church and accepted Jesus. And they followed me, my mother, my father, my brothers, everyone come to the church. For Jesus, it's impossible. But I didn't know how to take possession of the blessing. Then I wrote a book about that. Do you have that book here, How to Take Possession of the Blessing? I bring one, I'll show them. This is the book that everyone needs to know. I put in resume all that I learned. I wrote this book in 1985. It's come to 85, 15 years, 24, 39 years now, made in March. It's an adult book now, because it has 39 years. Then I used to pray every day. I used to open the Bible. I lived alone in Rio, and then I used to open the Bible and say this prayer. Father, please, hear what you says about my healing. I usually read to the Lord, Isaiah 53, verse 4 and 5. Let me get here to read for you. Isaiah 53, 45. Every day when I wake up, I used to do that. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. And we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised by our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripe we were healed. I used to say, Lord, please, forgive me. who is wrong? You are not a liar. You said that my sorrow, my pain, my sickness was upon Jesus. And he took them. This is the book. I speak about it later. Then I know that that's true. But Lord, if I don't use the glass, I have the headache. What's wrong? If I'm a sin, show me. I will ask forgiveness from you. I will stop doing that sin. But Jesus didn't speak nothing. It will last for 4 months. Then one day, I was reading a book, The Name of Jesus. And the author spoke many things. 2 things were new to me. One of them, that I did need to ask God to heal me. That's true. I should use the authority upon the devil. That all sickness, all disease, all temptations come from the devil. It's not a natural thing. You look to a woman as a man, and you desire her, or vice versa. You look at a man and desire him. No, each one needs a woman, or every man, and every woman needs a man. Then they date, get married, and be happy for all their life. The other belongs to other man. Leave her for other man, the same thing. The other man belongs to his wife. Leave him for his wife. Then I said, tell me where is my sin. I will confess to you, I repent now. And Jesus did say nothing, because the Bible says that. Then I was said that. When I read the book, I was in New York City, preaching there in that time. I was in the house of a Brazilian and the Portuguese, a couple. She was Brazilian, he Portuguese, that lived there. And they went to work. I was alone. When I read that, I should speak against the evil, because the Lord Jesus has healed me, was the first thing. The other thing is that the faith never moves mountain. Faith never moves mountain. Not faith. I need, my word should move mountains. Later I speak the other day about that for you, maybe Sunday, because it's very important. Think. Then I felt in my heart, I said, now, Lord, thank you. I was not the glass that time, it was a cold. Every week I had a problem. I put my finger here and I rebuked that. But come back to the glass and the headache. Lord, I don't accept this. This is not for me, this is for the people who don't know your word. But they know your word. Then I used to every day say, I don't like your glass. I spoke with the glass. I'm going to use you because I need you, but someday I'll throw you away. Then the day came that I took a decision. I was praying in my church. My church has a 1 hour prayer from 8 p.m. to 9 for a week. It was the purpose that the pastor did. So I said, after I leave here, I go to that church, another church. Very poor church. Old church, very twisted. And I went there. When I got in the church, it was 9:15 p.m. I look at my watch. It was 9:15. The pastor started the service 7:30. Incredible, but he didn't preach yet. When he got in the church, he said, let's read the Bible, stand up, and read the verse. I stood up, then sit down, and start to preach. 5 minutes. Very resumed message. I understood. He said, all of you that want the healing, stand up, please. I will stop. give a step ahead. I did that. Bow your head, I bowed. Close your eyes, I closed. And he began to say, you evil that are in desire, in his head, in this body, he rebuke every disease. I said, amen, I believe. So when he was rebuked, praying the rebuke, I felt like a wind passing by in my eyes. I took the glass, put it in my pocket, and said, I will never use you anymore. Amen. Never, never. Now, I was 20 years old. 56 years has passed. I'm 76. I don't need glass. I read small letters. Incredible, but the Lord healed me because I assumed my part, but not completely. Then come about New York City. When I read that book, my eyes were open. I said, that's now. I went to a mirror, look at my face, put my finger, say, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I say to you, come out of me. You cold, your disease, it doesn't matter the name that you have. I cast you out now in Jesus' name. Go! And he went away. 1985, 15, 39 years, 3 months later, I wrote this book. I said, I'll explain everything in that book. I have about 12 million, 13 million of this book circulating in the world in 13 languages. And praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I'm here to tell you, today is your day to take a possession. In the morning, I was praying the Lord 3 a.m. I come back to bed at 5. And it was a wonderful time with Jesus. A wonderful time. And now I'm going to speak for you about the Bartimaeus. But first of all, let's see the miracle of the Romania, please. Put for us.
We have all seen God's wonders taking place in Europe, and there's still more to come. As we left Timisoara, our pastor and leader, Dr. Suarez,
and his faith crew were on the long way to a... We have all seen God's wonders taking place in Europe, and there's still more to come. As we left Timisoara, our pastor and leader, Dr. Suarez, and his faith crew were on their long way to a quite distant city called Satumari in order to attend the next service, which starts off with the church members singing the victory lap song in Romanian.
Glorie, noi dăm glorie și haideți să facem cu toți turul victoriei.
After the church praised the Lord with beautiful songs, the moment of inspiration comes through the Word of God.
He is amazing. He works wonders.
El este minunat pentru că face minuni.
Like a circle that keeps getting bigger and bigger, and it never stops growing.
Este ca și un circul care crește, crește și niciodată se va opri.
The ones who have a walking impairment come to the altar so they can receive the blessing of healing, and the prayer brings the miracle.
I couldn't walk after the surgery.
When did it happen?
De cât timp?
2 years and 5 months ago.
Lift up your cane, put it on your shoulder. Make way for him here. Make way for him. Turn to that side. Walk now, brother. Keep walking, keep walking, keep walking. You're doing it, brother. Are you better? So keep walking. Are you getting better?
Yes, I'm better. I'm better.
Keep walking, keep walking, keep walking. Jesus, Jesus is working, folks. This is our Jesus, folks. Try running. Run a little, brother. Look at that, folks. Look at that. Brother, from now on, look, look, look. From now on, oh, he doesn't want to stop, folks. Look at that, brother, from now on. Oh, he doesn't want to stop, folks. Oh no! How did you walk before, sister?
With a lot of difficulty.
Was it difficult?
I felt a lot of pain in my legs,
my
knees.
Show us how you arrived here today, sister, like that. Walk normally now. Walk normally.
Umbla normal. Umbla normal. Numele lui Sus.
Now tell me, sister, are you better? Better?
Yes, I'm better. I don't feel
walk
any pain.
Walk that way now.
I'm fine now.
Keep walking, sister. Try running now. Run a little. Like this. Mind your step there. That's it.
I had never done this before.
Yes.
I had never done this before.
She had never run like that.
Lord. Amen.
Oh, look at that. Look at that, folks. That's...
I'm her son.
That's her son. You had never seen your mother run like that before.
No, not since I was born.
Uh-huh. Walk a little more, sister. You're getting better. Keep walking. Look. Walk like this. Look. Keep walking. Oh, she's in tears. Now turn around. Run now, sister. Run. Run like this. Come on. Look at that. Look at that, folks.
Aleluia.
That's it. Look at that. That's it.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Watch the incredible testimony of our brother who's a soccer player. At the altar, he runs like a professional athlete.
He's the one.
I played soccer for many years. But unfortunately, I haven't played for 2 years. I went to the doctor because I couldn't run anymore. My back also hurt when I made certain movements. But God worked in my life and my family's life. And ever since then, I have been following the Lord God's path. And now I can walk normally.
Show us how you walked before. Show us, brother, so that everyone can see. How did you walk before, brother? He walked like that. Let's run now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Turn around. Amen. Keep going, brother. You are healed now. Run. Hallelujah. You are healed now. You are healed. Oh, he doesn't want to stop running.
I am completely healed. I tried to walk many times, but I could only run like this.
Like that?
Yes, like this.
And now?
I tried running before, but I couldn't. But now I can. Now I can run like I used to, like a professional player. I can run, as you have seen. I can run really fast, like an 18-year-old. I used to play in Hungary. I played professionally for many years. I also played in the Romanian League. But unfortunately, due to an illness, I had to stop. And ever since the service, I feel that I have been healed.
Let us applaud the Lord. Open in Mark chapter 10, verse 46. And they came to Jericho. What he went to do in Jericho? The same thing that he has done in other parts. What the Lord Jesus brought me here, because he wants to make miracles, as he always did in our midst and when he was in the earth. So he passed some time in Jericho. He went to the house of Simon, and there he showed himself and to the owner of the house, and there was salvation at the house. And the people watched Jesus save many people and deliver others. Then he went out of Jericho. And as he went out of Jericho with his disciples, and a great number of people. Yesterday I spoke about that. When Jesus went out of Jericho, he went there with his disciples. There was a large crowd following him. And I said to our people yesterday, said the same thing to you. We have to learn from Jesus. And all of you can be in a ministry of the blessings of the God, of the New Testament. Why? Because the Lord Jesus has made us blessed, to bless the people with the healing, the deliverance, the salvation. You are not too old to start now to talk to your family, to your friends, to your neighbors, to other people that you meet, and to tell about Jesus. We cannot be ashamed of people. I don't know to talk with Jesus. But sometimes we do talk about other people's and bad things. But with Jesus, we talk only good things. What he has done for us. What we learned in the church. What you saw, he healed the people. A church like this one should never close. In Brazil, you have at least 3 services a day. But most of the church, we have 6 services a day. Some of the services is not so big. Come 20 people, 30 people. But this is a big crowd for the people that don't know the gospel. And with the anointing that you have, we can teach them about Jesus and make them disciples of the Lord Jesus. He went with his disciples. But when he came out, there was a large crowd with him. We must work for Jesus 24 hours a day in our work. You know, in our neighborhood, we meet people that are suffering. We tell about Jesus. Do that, do that. I was a young man. I was in a bus in Rio. It was rainy. When I passed a street, the bus stopped for some people to go out, others to come in. So I saw a girl in the street with this mother. She was sat in the sidewalk. It was raining. She was wept. And she had a problem. She all the time was that way. And the people used to give some alms to them. The Lord talked in my heart. I keep the sign. I got out of the bus and went to talk with his mother. What? Who is she? Is your daughter? Yes. What she has? Since the birth, she's that way. I have done everything that I can, but no doctor could help her. I said, I know a place that you can take her, and she'll be healed. Is that true? Yes. I took a card of my church and said, please, Wednesday, 7:30 p.m., go there. And she, are you? Then I was there when I came. She was there when I came before 7:30. She was with the girl along the wall doing the same thing. I passed, attended the service, the pastor prayed, I went out. Next week, she was there. The girl was in that way. She's improving. Another week, and she was. Then she was healed. I felt so happy that I said, God, thank you. My eyes saw you do a miracle. If I didn't speak to that mother that day, she continued that way. I don't know where she is now, if she died or not. Many years has passed. I was 20 years, about 20 years old, and 56 years more. But I was so happy, never forgot this. The Lord wants to use you, and you never you forget what he's going to do through you. Yes, in your neighborhood, in your work, all the time offer a prayer. Pastor Jaime in São Paulo is our pastor leader. His family was very, very poor. They lived in Islam, next to Islam, and his brother was poor too. But he se converted, told the family, brought his family, and his brother began to play soccer. In 1982, there was a World Cup in Los Angeles. His brother was one of the players. Jorginho is his name. Famous. Today is a coach in some country in Asia, teaching the boys to play football. Coach of a good team there. Then what he did? Oh, some man told his mother about us. And he came, and the Lord delivered them from his witchcraft and things of the devil. And all the family was set free, and they began to prosper. Because God's word prospered. The blessing of the Lord prosper us. We should do that. But are you praying for the sick? Yes, you can pray for the sick. There is no sin on that. But if you learn to take authority upon the pain, upon the infirmities, the Lord bless. Jorginho was playing soccer for 3 or 4 years. He was playing in Flamengo, a good team in Brazil. Then one of his friend, the player, told him, Jorginho, please, you are a pastor? Not yet. Pray for me now. I have a stomach ache. I don't know what's happening. It's now. Excuse me. Put his hand and say, headache, come out of him. He said, incredible. I'm healed. What you did to me, pastor? I use God's power. You should use God's power. When you begin to serve the Lord, you'll be more holy than you are now, because you are in contact with God. If you have some weakness, the Lord will heal your weakness. You'll be a strong person. Now, man of God, I'm doing his work, and the Lord is blessing you. That's true. So Jesus got a big crowd when he went from Jericho. How many days? I don't know. But he was 24 hours a day being used by God. He wanted the people delivered. And now the same thing. He is with us, within us. He guides us in success. He guides us to deliver people from their infirmities, their diseases, their temptations. Many of them sometimes have demons. We cast out the devils. But if a person has a strong demon, what could I suffer with that? Nothing. Look at the Luke chapter 10, verse 19. This is very important for you. The Lord Jesus has sent 70 his disciples, 2 by 2, to go before him, to tell the people that he was going there. And he said, heal the sick, on. He didn't say, cast out devil. For the Sabbath, he did say that. You go and preach, say that the King of God is coming, that he'll be there in such a day, and heal the sick, not pray for the sick. Heal the sick. It's different. We have a shame, we don't have a strong faith because we never read the Bible, so our faith is weak. But when your faith grows, you learn to cast out the devils and to heal the sick. The 70 went back to Jesus and said, Lord, it's wonderful to work for you. Why? Because in your name, even the demons went out. He said to them, assim, I saw Satan falling from heaven. That's normal in our ministry. But what the Lord said to them, verse 19, it's for you to grab this verse. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions. What is that? To destroy. Serpents and scorpions is a figure of the worst demons that exist in hell. The ones that make evil to any person that enter in contact with him. I give you power to tread, to step, destroy serpent and scorpio, and over all the power of the enemy. Brother, over all the power of the enemy. He gave us power. Maybe you are bound by spirit, evil spirit. I have desires, dirty desires. I want to kill myself, to kill the person. This is the work of the devil. But the Lord gave us power over the devils. All of them, all the power of the enemy. Oh, there are strong demons. I have power upon them, you must say. It doesn't matter for me if it's strong or not. I have power over all the power of the enemy, the Lord Jesus gave us. And he continues saying, over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Don't be afraid. Be faithful, strong. I will change my life. I will change completely. If you decide to be a blessed one, you must do the work. One day the Lord Jesus passing by a place, and there was a man blind. He was born blind. And the disciples said, Lord, who sinned for him to be born blind? He or his father? It doesn't matter. But he could not have sinned because he was not born. It's a question without meaning. And the Lord is, it doesn't matter who sinned. But if you want the work of the Lord be done on him, we must do his work now. Jesus called him, split on the ground, make some mud, and pass in the eyes, go to the Siloam tank, and wash yourself. He didn't took the man there. He was blind. And he went, I'm the right way to Siloam tank. Yes. Jesus, oh, thank you. He washed his eyes, hoping that he was healed. He never saw before. He was wondering, oh, the trees, what is that? The tree, oh, it's very nice, it's green. What is that? That is a horse, a cow. And he came so happy to Jesus. Thank you. We can do that. If you preach the gospel, if we teach the people, the Lord will deliver us. One day I heard in Rio that the wife of a cousin was speaking bad things, like a crazy woman, and they taught her to put her in the hospital for crazy people, and for her, he'll come out. But I felt in my heart, I went to my hometown. I live in Rio, and I got there. I was a single man in that time, but a man of God. I went there, and my aunt said to me, did you hear about the wife of John? I said, I never heard about that. How I can visit her? Oh, I can take you there. You went there. It was a poor house. He grows vegetables for a living. And I got there, and she came. She was a little crazy. I have a daughter with the owner of this company. And the person, all the family, no. Yes, I had. You took my daughter out. My daughter was so nice. She was like a monkey. But that is my daughter. But that's true. That's not true. That's false. I said to the husband, can I take her to her room and talk with her? Yes, you may take. I said, please come with me. Open the door. Sit in your bed. You are going to bring my boy, my daughter, because you're like a monkey, but it's my daughter, my boy. Foi assim. Wait a minute. You are a faithful woman. You never did what you say. That's false. If you continue that, they'll put you in the hospital for crazy people. Every day you are going to take a big injection and the electric shock. Obrigado. Electric shock. I get emotional and the water sometimes holds that sometimes in the interior and give me problem. I said to him, I will pray for you now in Jesus' name. I will cast every spirit from you and you'll be healed now. Do you believe? I said, so yes. I put my hand and say, devil, this woman belongs to Jesus. She never sinned. She never had a daughter or a baby. In the name of Jesus, stop now. And my uncle, my aunt asked me, it was your aunt, had a manifestation. She's healed. She never spoke this again. She needed someone to make a prayer to cast the devil out without manifestation. Sometimes there is manifestation, no problem, if there is or not. And never more she spoke that thing. She became a normal woman. What am I going to say to you? Do God's work. Be one of the crowd of the Lord. Follow him. Come to the church. Sunday will be here. Pastor Santos is here Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. Bring your faith to Jesus. Jesus, I need my faith to grow. Help me. Give me the word. You change your objective in the life. I will be different now. You grow in faith. You be strong person. Maybe today you are a strong, a weak woman or a weak man. But after today, no. You go strong. You see the world with another eyes. Because all of us are owners of the world. If someone is prospering, why not us? If someone is happy, why not us? There is no second class of people. All of us are prime class. We are made in his image. We cannot accept that. Read the Bible. Begin to practice the word. Evangelize. Bring the sick. When you see one of the people that you brought to the church, changed, healed, prospered, you get happy. Oh, praise the Lord. I fulfill my place in the world. God brought me here to represent him. Let's come again to the Bible. So, a great number of people, blood Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway, side begging. Many of us are sat by the highway. Jesus said, I'm the way. We are sat by the way, begging. No. Let us stop to beg. Let us call for Jesus today, and after today, we will continue his presence. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to the church to learn more. Read the Bible, pray at home as much as you can. But when it comes to healing people, you must exercise your authority. I have authority to tread, to step on scorpions, serpents, all that similar things, or over all the power of the enemy. Never say, I cannot do that. You can do. Next Wednesday, you are going in this nation to have election. Go to vote. Vote in the best path that you feel. You are a citizen of heaven, of the country. Who you indicate? No, you choose. I don't indicate no one. You choose the best and vote. You are a citizen. Learn to do to exercise your right. You have the right to vote. Go vote and pray for the Lord. My country will be a blessing. Because the Bible says, blessed is the nation that the Lord is that the God is the Lord. Everyone that is repent of his sin became a blessing to the nation. And this nation must occupy the place that the Lord established for you. You are a good nation, good people. Then you can do the difference in Africa. And pray for other countries also, and the Lord will do the same thing. I do the same thing for my country. You do. The Bible says that. In a few years, the things will change here for better. And then you have a normal life, because when you are begging on the way, set begging, you are not occupying your position in Christ. Your position in Christ is to be a king. The Bible says that. Revelation 5, 9, and 10. And I will stop to pray in a few minutes. Revelation chapter 5, 9 and 10. What is your position before God? Verse 9. E they sang a new song, saying, "Do our worth to take the book, and to open the seals therefore. For thou wast slain, and hast redeemed us to God by the blood out of every kindred, and tongue, and people, and nation. And now, and hast made us unto our God kings and priests, and shall reign on the earth." He has made unto our God king and priest. As priest, pay attention to that. Everywhere that you are, every time, during the day, the night, you can minister to God as priest. You have access to his throne. You are authorized to do that. Lord, I come before you because I'm hungry, because I have the money to pay the rent, because I need that. And I came to thank you for every word that you have given me. I'm growing faith, priest. Yes, king. For God, you are a king. He does need to say, "Pen, go from that person." You do that. You are a king. You have authority. No one you say to the king, "What are you doing?" "I'm doing what I want because I'm a king," to God. Let's read the verse 10 again. "And he has made us unto our God." Jesus made us. Who told you? Who authorized you to be a king? Jesus. He made me a king to our God, kings and priests. "And we shall reign on the earth."